Looking for a way to safely roll out features? Stay tuned and we'll show you how with Datadog Feature Flags.
Hello, and welcome to This Month in Datadog, where we'll update you on our latest features, product announcement, events, and more. This month, we put the spotlight on reducing the risk of your feature flag rollouts with Datadog Feature Flags. We also cover how to troubleshoot network slowdowns, track Claude usage and cost data, and gain new logging capabilities, including migrating historical logs. But before we get to those, let's talk about a new area of focus for security teams and navigating our current AI era. We recently published a three-part series that's essential reading for anyone who wants to learn about security threats targeting AI applications. Each post dives into common attacks targeting one of three different components of an AI application, and also covers how you can minimize risks to these components. Next, if you're looking for a guide to help you make sense of our current AI era, check out our AI Tools Lab. This series by Datadog Advocates explores different aspects of AI tools, their practical applications in software development, and so much more. Recent episodes dig into the latest AI news, OpenRouter, and vibe coding tools. You can watch episodes of AI Tools Lab by visiting the show's website. The series about threats to AI applications is on our blog. We'll link to both in the video's description. As always, be sure to subscribe to our channel, and while you're at it, give us a like, drop us a comment, or send us an email with your questions or suggestions. And now, on with the show. Kicking things off is how you can more easily troubleshoot network issues with Datadog Network Path, which visualizes traffic between applications. With this new view, you get an overview of sources, destinations, packet loss, and round-trip latency. Digging into a test, you can see intermediate traffic hops between a source and a destination, as well as end-to-end latency and packet loss, enabling you to pinpoint the root cause of network problems. On top of that, Network Path shows you which devices in on-premise networks were traversed by application traffic. Selecting one of these devices, you can pivot to network device monitoring to investigate them even further. Log into the platform today to start using Network Path. Next, let's turn to your ability to track Claude usage and cost data with our new Cloud Cost Management integration. Managing the cost of foundation models is a critical challenge, especially for teams for using powerful models like Claude Opus. Now, CCM integrates with the Anthropic Usage and Cost Admin API, allowing you to ingest Claude usage and cost data directly into dashboards, reports, and monitors. And with our pre-built dashboards, you get an overview of total tokens alongside total cost, as well as valuable insights into token usage, cost analysis, including daily and total spend, a distribution of costs by workspace and model, and a breakdown by token type. Log into Datadog today to check out our new integration and all the insights it can give you. And rounding out our segment is how you can gain additional logging capabilities with our new custom processor, which enables you to take advantage of vector remap language. With this new processor, you can now use VRL to transform your logs, enabling use cases like migrating historical logs from vendors, including Splunk and Sumo Logic. You can also ensure cost control rules work with your log formats and so much more. The custom processor is available in observability pipelines. Log into the platform to see what you can do with this new feature, or check out our guide with popular use cases helping you get started today. That was just a sneak peek of the many features we released this month. For a full list, visit the link shown. This month, we're putting the spotlight on Datadog feature flags. Here's Aaron to tell you more.
Thanks, Jeremy. Hi, everyone. I'm an engineering manager here at Datadog, and I joined the company with its acquisition of Eppo, a feature flagging and experimentation tool. Releasing new features is one of the riskiest things we can do as software engineers, because that's when existing functionality is most likely to break. Feature flags is one tool to help reduce that risk, and observability is another. We're excited to announce that we've combined these tools into a powerful integrated flagging solution. Datadog feature flags enable you to safely roll out features with advanced targeting, built-in observability, and automatic rollbacks. In Datadog, you can now create feature flags ranging from simple Boolean on-off switches to sophisticated multivariant JSON-valued flags. You can apply targeting rules that let you change flag behavior based on user properties, and you can chain them together to create evaluation waterfalls that are tailored to your use cases. Flag variants can be rolled out instantly or done so progressively as a canary rollout, with Datadog monitoring key guardrail metrics. The canary rollout can be configured to automatically pause or roll back if Datadog detects a meaningful negative change. Datadog surfaces real-time flag evaluation information, including exposures, errors, and latency, all segmented by variant. This information is linked with Datadog's rich observability tooling. For example, you can pull up errors that a flag variant is encountering, explore them in real user monitoring, and pull up a relevant session replay. On top of that, Datadog's feature flags are incorporated into your code using providers for Open Feature, the vendor-agnostic open specification feature flagging API. Datadog feature flags are available in limited preview. Check out this video's description where you can find a sign-up page to access this new product. And now back to Jeremy.
Thanks, Aaron. Earlier this month, we hosted our San Francisco Summit, which was packed with interesting sessions. Now we're sharing those with you on our YouTube channel. Head over to our channel to watch these sessions or visit our Summit Hub to see where we're hosting future summits. We'll link to both in this video's description. And that wraps up today's episode. Check back in with us next month for more on our latest releases and announcements. See you next month.